thank you for coming today. Appreciate you being here. A couple of official announcements. This project is made possible with funds from the Decentralization Program, a REIT grant program with the New York State Council of the Arts, with the support of Governor Andrew M. Cuomo and the New York State Legislature, and administered by Arts Mint Hudson. So I want to thank Arts Mint Hudson because they gave us a grant for this event. Number two, I have two sponsors to thank. One is Quest Financial Services in Goshen, New York, and also Outdoors in Chester, New York. There's a coupon on your seat. There's a little coupon on your seat, too, for Outdoors. I want a special thanks, I don't think he's in the room, there he is, Walt Papalo, close enough. Walt runs this building and the arts in the town of Chester, and on very short notice, he worked it out so that we could have this room today. So thank you very much. I want to thank our sound man, Jim Elwell, who's been doing sound for Music for Humanity for almost 20 years. So what do we do? Music for Humanity. We just spread more music, because more music means a better world for all of us. Yes. So, you know, there's lots of ways you can help. You've got a flyer, 11 ways how you can help. But, you know, I discovered this year the best way to help Music for Humanity. Please raise your hand if you're on Facebook. Anybody on Facebook? The easiest way to help Music for Humanity is when your birthday runs around, and a few people did this on their own, I didn't ask them this year, all of a sudden, they were running fundraisers, birthday fundraisers for Music for Humanity. And it's like, wow. I do it every year, I've been doing it every year for the last few years. But that is the simplest and easiest way to raise money for Music for Humanity. It's unbelievable. The other way is if you shop on Amazon, is you can go to, I think it's smile.amazon.com, and you can select Music for Humanity as your charity of choice. And then whenever you spend money on Amazon, they will give 0.5% to Music for Humanity, and every once in a while, maybe every quarter, I get a check for $20, $30, $40, depending on how much people are spending on Amazon. So keep that in mind. And that's all I have to say for now. I may say something later, but I'm really glad you're here. I know that when you leave here, some of you know John Sheehan. Most of you don't know Tony DiPaolo, but when you go home tonight, you're gonna say, that was amazing. So without any further ado, please welcome my friend, John Sheehan. Yeah.
I played a party here once, and then the first time I was here was back around 93 or 95 or something like that, maybe a little later than that, with Harvey Reed. Okay, here's what I got in mind for today. I have two guitars, obviously. One's a nylon string classical. The other is a steel string, and my recorded music is a mix of original music that's influenced by steel string Americana roots, or American roots music, blues and country, and so forth, and European classical influences. I'll be playing mostly original music, however, I want to give a nod to John Fahey with this first song. Who was a steel string pioneer in the 60s, composing guitarist. And Davy Graham, the great British guitarist who influenced a lot of American and British players. Then when I go to the nylon string, perhaps you'll hear more European or classical influence in my playing. But, John Fahey's song called Poor Boy Long Ways From Home. At least one of you already guessed that before I even started. You knew where I was going, David Schiff. Guitarists are fond of tuning to different tunings and playing, finding new sounds. This is a tuning. It was in open D tuning, open D chord. Fahey wrote that way. This one's in dadgad, and this takes. You like dadgad? Yes, yeah, it's a very sweet tuning. And Davy Graham, I don't know if everyone agrees on this, but Davy Graham, the British guitarist, was credited with actually coming up with this tuning first by jamming with Moroccan players. A lot of British and Celtic players use this tuning. So this is a tune of mine called Buggy Ride. Thank you. Thank you very much. This next one was one of my more lucrative compositions. It was used on a TV commercial in Great Britain and Ireland for about 6 months. Digital company decided it was humorous enough to put footage of Animal Planet footage of penguins jumping through an ice hole. I was kind of hoping a dance craze was going to happen, but they call a dance the penguin or something, but never happened. A truck with the proceeds from this song, so it's dear to my heart. Of course, the truck is on its last leg. Yeah, I need another hit, right. Something about penguins, since that's catching on. Okay. Thank you. instrumental solo guitar. It's called Freedom Place. That one showed up on a WFPU compilation a long time ago. Don't ask me when. Okay, here's I owe this one to Barry. I'm in debt, and I'm going to settle the debt now. You remember, Carol?
I do.
Yeah. Yep. Okay. I got this from a 45 collection of mine. I have a box of about 150 instrumental 45 RPM records. Everybody here looks like they know what that is. I once had a young student, and his father comes, and I was teaching him, and I had 45s all over the place, and he goes, "Yeah, I heard about that on the History Channel." I've been looking in the mirror ever since to see the age line. All right. I'm not going to tell you the title. I want to know if you recognize it, because that means I'm playing it right. Thank you. very much. That was written by a fellow named Carl Hagen. This is his first name, Earl Hagen. And the recording that I have is by the Viscounts. Madison Records. I just love that record so much. It's a 1959 record. It's in the first slot of my 150 instrumental 45 RPMs. I know right where it is, and I know when it's missing, in case any friends have been over that envy that record. I don't know where I got it, but I'm so glad I got it. I need another copy. All right, here's my last steel strength number. It's called Insomnia.
You're not gonna tell them the name of it.
What's that? Oh, I thought you knew that. Oh, you mean the other song, Harlem Nocturne. Harlem Nocturne. Oh, I'm sorry. Thanks, Dave. I'm glad you brought that out. Yes, it was. Yes, I think it was Mickey Splane or something like that. It was a theme song, yes. Earl Hagen wrote for film and TV. Thanks. Where would I be without you, David? I don't just... Let me just check my tuning. Okay, here we go. Insomnia. It's also on my first CD. Thank you.
Not bad, John.
Thanks. I reduced my fishing time in order to practice up for this. Well, I reduced it. I didn't give it up. That would be sacrificial.
Thanks, John.
You're most welcome, Barry. Thank you for doing this, and thank everybody for coming out. Jim's excellent sound work. Yeah. Tony Capalla. Yeah. And you made it. Here you are. Okay, now I'll try to adjust my touch here on a different instrument.
John, plug in.
Yeah, that's a great idea, Jim. Yeah.
Do I have to do everything?
Yeah, would you play my set for me? And I'm gonna go out for a beer.
Do I have to bring the monitor up a little?
Let's find out. Let's just check the monitor once again. What's that? No, I don't hear it. I don't hear it at all. I don't hear anything, Jim. Is it no, I don't want to say anything.
Play something.
Looks like
no, it's on. Okay, we're coming back a lot.
I don't hear anything really, Jim. Did this loosen up?
I am not sure. I don't think so. Is there anything you need? Dark.
Was the mute button on?
Okay, try it.
Down so that the bass doesn't feedback, but I get more monitor. Sorry about this, folks, but this is what you got to do. All right, let's go with that. All right, in your book, 50 Hikes of New Jersey, this number 10 is Governor Mountain, the name of this song, around where I live. Very nice little hike.
Thank you.
start messing up, I think. So it's my fault, it's none of yours. I mentioned Davy Graham before. Not a lot of people that are into popular music know about this guy, but he's very important. And certainly Jimmy Page from Led Zeppelin was very aware of Davy Graham, and so are a lot of other guitarists. And I'm going to do a Davy Graham song now. I definitely wanted this show to, I wanted to take my hat off to Davy Graham and John Fahey, because they did a lot of instrumental fingerstyle solo guitar, and it wasn't always well accepted, but they did it anyway. And he caught on. I'd also like to thank Segovia, of course. Linda, I saw Segovia play once when he was 93 years old. It was unbelievable. All right, this one's called Finger Buster.
Thank you. Thank you. Mm-hmm.